Hello students, now in this video let's continue with a spanning tree. So now first of all, before going towards the further part, let me take weighted graph. What is in my weighted graph? Many problems can be modeled using graphs with weights assigned to their edges. For example, if the vertices denote the cities and the edges represent the roads connecting them, then the weights assigned to the edges may represent distance between two cities, right? In such a problem, we require to find a path of least length between any two vertices in a network. This can be solved if we find spanning tree of a given graph having least weight. In this section, we will see two methods for finding such a minimal or shortest spanning tree. So, weighted graph, in short we can say a graph G in which each edge is assigned a number is called a weighted graph, right? Now, for your simplicity, let me give the definition. Weighted graph a graph G in which A graph G in which each edge is assigned a number is called a weighted graph. Okay. Now, the number assigned to the edge E is called as the weight of edge E, and is denoted by W of E. The sum of the weights of all edges in a graph G in a graph G is called as weight of G and is denoted by W of G. For example, sometimes we have a question. For example, for the weighted graph draw a spanning tree also write down or also write its weight. Whose weight? The weight of spanning tree. First of all, for the weighted graph we have to draw a spanning tree. So what the graph given to us? First let me draw the graph given to us. Suppose this is V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. And the weights 1, 2, 4, 3, 2, 2, 5. So now let's draw a spanning tree of it, and later on let me find its weight. So solution. Suppose let me take a spanning tree. We need to take all the vertices in a spanning tree, right? Now there are 6 vertices, so it should have 5 edges. So spanning tree having n vertices has n minus 1 edges, v6. So let me take these. If I take these 5 edges, then it will be a spanning tree, right? These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 edges are there. So let me take its weights are 2, 1, 2, 5 and what? 2. So now let's do the sum. W of, let it be T1 or T, let it be T. A spanning tree is denoted by T, right? And the weight of T is what? 2 plus 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 2. So that is how much? This is 12, right? This is one of the spanning tree of it. And its weight we can determine by doing the sum of weights of the edges in that tree, right? Now, the next part we have to see. We have to determine shortest spanning tree, okay? Now, shortest spanning tree, as we say earlier that, while before writing the definition of weighted graph, I had already taught you. Suppose this is a graph and these are 4 cities are these, okay? These vertices denote the cities and the edges are nothing but the road to travel through these cities, right? Now, again, suppose these edges having few weights, that is nothing but the distance from these cities, distance between them. Suppose this is 10, 20, this is 30, this is suppose 15, as such. These are what distances of these one. Suppose this is 18, 16 as such. Suppose these are in kilometers and these distances are there. Now we have to determine the shortest spanning tree. Spanning tree is what? The graph, a subgraph of this one, but it is a connected circuitless graph, right? Having 4 cities are there as it is. Now we have to determine the shortest spanning tree, means a spanning tree with minimum weight. Just we have seen an example while we have drawn a tree there, spanning tree there, and whose weight we have been determined. So similarly here, a spanning tree we have to draw. Now there are various spanning trees we can draw. It depends on the graph, right? So from that graph we have to determine such a spanning tree whose weight will be what? Minimum. So now here if you look, which is the minimum weight here? 15 is the minimum weight, 16 is before, 10 is the minimum weight. So let me draw this edge first, 10, with weight 10. Then 15 is the minimum. So this edge having a weight 15, right? Now this edge having a weight 16. But if I draw this edge here, then it will become a circuit. But our tree is what? Circuitless graph. So we can't draw this one, right? Then after 16, there will be an 18 is the next one, right? So I can draw this 18 here. So these are what? This is one of the spanning tree. There are 4 vertices, 3 edges are there. This is one of the spanning tree having minimum weight. This algorithm is known as Kruskal's algorithm. We have to see, there are various algorithms for determining the shortest spanning tree, but among them, this way, whatever I have been explained now, I will take the weights in ascending order. I had taken 10, then 15, then 16. I eliminate 16 because if we take that edge, then it will become a circuit. That's why I won't take 16 here. I will directly take 18. So this algorithm is known as Kruskal's algorithm. And one more algorithm we have to see, that is Prim's algorithm. In that algorithm, now suppose these are vertices V1, or let me A, B, C and D. In Prim's algorithm, we have to, suppose I had taken a vertex B, okay, then I have to take a minimum weight age from it. So this will I'll take B to C. Then from again the next weight will be from B. How many ages are there from B? B incident ages on B are what? This BC, BD and what? BA. These three ages. So among them, which are the minimum, that one we will draw first. Later on we will go for the next part. Now again from B, this 15 is the minimum. So I will draw this 15 up to D. Then now later, this minimum ages from B to other vertices are over, right? So now the next one we will take either C or D. Now from C to D there is an age, but that value, that age will create a circuit again. So let me see to D. Now from D, there is only one age remains up to A, and which gives a circuitless graph, and that is also what? A tree with minimum weight. So this algorithm is what? Prim's algorithm. And this is what? Kruskal's algorithm. This is the way of Kruskal's algorithm and this is of Prim's algorithm. Now let me take these one by one. Let me give first the definition of spanning tree and let's solve the examples on these algorithms with the algorithm. Let me write the algorithms first and let me solve the examples. A tree or a spanning tree with minimum weight. A spanning tree with minimum weight, right? Now to find shortest spanning tree, we have to study two algorithms. First one, Kruskal's algorithm. Now let me take the steps of it. Kruskal's algorithm. What is the procedure here? Or the steps of it. Step 1. Select an age E1 of G such that E1 is not a loop. E1 is not a loop and weight of E1 is minimum. As we seen an example, in that one I had taken the vertices as cities and edges are the roads in between them and the weights are nothing but distances from one city to another city. Now always while traveling we know that we want to go by road, but whenever we need to go by road we choose a minimum distance way, right? That's why the same that type of example I had taken here. So same thing we'll have to do here. If such a age we have to choose which should not a loop and whose weight is what? A minimum. Then step 2, if the ages E1, E2 and so on up to EK have been selected. Suppose these many ages we have been selected, then select an age EK plus 1, the next age how does we can select the next age ek plus 1 from remaining ages, from remaining ages, but that has some condition. Remaining ages such that, remaining ages such that, first thing, weight of ek plus 1 is as small as possible, as small as possible. Okay, second thing we should keep in mind, ek plus 1 does not form, ek plus 1 does not form a circuit, ek plus 1 doesn't form a circuit with previously chosen ages. The same thing I have been explained to you while taking, while taken example, previously chosen ages. It shouldn't have, the weight of that next age should be minimum, and what, it shouldn't form a circuit with previous ages, right? Then step 3, step 3, and this is the last step. If n minus 1 ages are selected, if n minus 1 ages are selected, then stop. Then stop. Otherwise what? Repeat. Otherwise repeat step 2. Otherwise repeat step 2. This is an algorithm. This is Kruskal's algorithm in which the ages we have to take, right? Now let's take an example on it. Example says that using Kruskal's algorithm, find shortest spanning tree for this graph. This graph G is given to us, suppose having these vertices A, B, C, D, E, F and G. Okay, these 7 vertices are there, and these ages having these weights. Now let me give numbering to these ages. Suppose this is E1, let it be E2, then E3, next suppose this is E4, suppose this is E5, let it be E5, okay, then E6, E7, E8, E9 and what, E10. So 10 ages are there, right? Now solution, we have to determine a shortest spanning tree. Now first of all, let me take these ages and their weights. Let me write them, ages. So ages are what? E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, E7, E8 and what? E9, E10, right? Now their weights. Weights, E1 having a weight 2, E2 having weight 3, E3 having weight 2, E4 having weight 1, E5 having weight 2, E6 having weight 1, E7 having weight 2, E8 having weight 5 and what? 7. These are weights and the ages and the weights, right? Now we arrange the ages in non decreasing, or we can say ascending order of their weights. Okay, so again let me write. Now first of all I need to write weights, then ages and then weights. So I can take these two ages first, E4, E6, having weights 1, 1. Then of 2, 2 we have to take. So E1, E3 and E7 let me take. 2, 2, 2. Fine. Then 3 is E2 having weight 3. Then 5, 4 2s are there, sorry. So here E7 and what? E5 is there. E5 having weight 2. E7 having weight 2. Then we have to take E2 having weight 3. Then E8, 5. E9, 5. And what? Next one, E10 having weight 7. This is an ascending order of them. Now, let me write all the vertices first for spanning tree. While drawing spanning tree, let me write all vertices. I had written all the vertices. This is A, B, C, D, E, F and what? G. Now, I will draw first E4. Where is E4? Look at here. This is between F and G. So, let me draw this E4. Having how much weight? 1. Right? Then, next one, E6. Look at E6. E6 is between B and G. This one, E6, having weight 1. It won't form a circuit, that's why we have taken this. E6 is here. Then E1, where is E1? It is from B to A. We can take it because it doesn't form a circuit. So 2, this is for E1, right? Then, now here we can't take a edge because it forms a circuit, right? So now, E1 we have taken, E3. Next one is E3. So this edge we can take. This is what? E3. Having weight 2. Then next one E5. Now this is E5. This between G to E. We can't take this because it forms this circuit. So we avoid it. Right? Then E7 having weight 2. So this is what? E7. So, we can take it. E7 having weight 2. Right? Then next, E2. E2 having weight 3. This one, as I say, we can take it. Right? Then E8. So, E8 is between E and D. So, we can take it. E8 having weight 5. So, now, look at how many edges. Now, near about all vertices are covered, no one will remain isolated. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 vertices are there. 6 edges we have taken. So, this is our spanning tree. This is the shortest spanning tree we can say. This is required shortest spanning tree in this graph. The same one we have to determine. This is the way of solving an example using Kruskal's algorithm. We have to write all the vertices and draw one by one edge so that the weight of that edge should be minimum and it won't form a circuit with previously chosen edges. These two things you have to remember. And whenever we got n minus 1 edges, we have to stop. Now, how does I get that n minus edges are over? These two edges are left only, E9 and E10. Look at E9, if I take here, then it forms a circuit again. And if E10 will take, it forms a circuit. So, count the number of edges. If these are n minus 1, we get a shortest spanning tree. Okay. Now, let me give one example of this Kruskal's algorithm as an homework to you. And let me go for the Prim's algorithm. So, homework is this. Homework. Using Kruskal's algorithm, find shortest spanning tree for. Now, let me draw a graph for you. You have to do this. Let it be A, B, C, D, E, F and again G. So 7 vertices, so 6 edges we need. Suppose this weight is 5, 15, 3, 5, 5, 5, 4, 15 and this one 18. So find here the shortest spanning tree of this graph G using Kruskal's algorithm. Now let me go for Prim's algorithm. Second algorithm for finding shortest spanning tree is Prim's algorithm. So let's rewrite the steps of it. Step 1. Select. Now obviously in example this is given to us. Let G be a connected graph with n vertices. This is given to us with n vertices, right? Now among these one, select any vertex v1 of G. Select any vertex v1 of G. That is your first step. Step 2. Select an edge e1. Select an edge e1 of G such that e1 is not a self loop. E1 is not a self loop. And E1 is having minimum weight. E1 is having minimum weight among all edges incident on V1. Okay. Then step 3 says that if suppose E1, E2, so on up to EI are the selected edges with end vertices v1, v2 and so on up to what? vi plus 1. Then we select an edge ei plus 1 then we select an edge ei plus 1 of minimum weight such that one vertex of ei plus 1 one vertex of ei plus 1 belongs to whom? This v1, v2 and so on up to what? vi plus 1. And the other end vertex does not belong to the vertex set, this v1, v2 and so on up to what? vi plus 1, means that one will be the other vertex than this one, right? After selecting some of the edges, later on when we go for the next edge, that next edge incident vertices on that. So one vertex should belongs to the previous vertices, but other shouldn't belongs to the previous vertices, right? Step 4 says that if n minus 1 edges are selected, then stop. Otherwise, repeat step 3. Right. Now let's take an example on it. example says that use Prim's algorithm to find minimal means the shortest spanning tree in a graph G. This is our graph G given to us having these vertices, six vertices, and their edges with the weights are given to us. So now here out of these six vertices we have to select any one vertex from this, right? So now solution, let me select this vertex D having 5 edges incident on it. So let it be D. Okay. Now, if you observe 5 edges incident on it, but the edge with minimum weight, that one we have to select first. So suppose this edge is having a minimum weight, this one also is of minimum weight. Now here trial and now here it is your choice that which edge you want to select, either this one or this one you can do, right? So now let me select it up to E having a weight 1, right? Then the other student can select this one also, doesn't matter, fine, it will be same. Now the next part, again we have to look for remaining 4 edges which are incident on it. So we have to select again edge of minimum weight out of them, right? So now let me take this DF now. So if you have selected DF first, then the second choice will be DE again. It is one at the same. Now the next thing, the edges incident on D are again this DA, DB and DC. So 2, 2, 3 are the weights of them respectively, right? So among these 2, 2 are the minimum. So let me take this 2 up to A. Suppose this is up to A. Our one vertex should be the same one which is among these 3, but the other vertex shouldn't be the same one, right? So that will be A here, that is our step 3 says. The next is again we can take this DB. So let me take this DB having weight 2, right? It one forms a circuit, that's why we can easily select that one again, right? Then next one DC, we can take this DC also here, what, but that has a weight 3, while other than that this 2 are left here. So this 2 we can't select because it forms a circuit, but this 2 we can take. Look at this edge from B to C, we can take having a weight 2. This 3 we can't take because it gives a means it will be a spanning tree but having a maximum weight than this tree, right? Now here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 edges are there, 6 number of vertices are there, so this is our required spanning tree. So this one here we get 5 edges, so we will stop here. This is our required spanning tree and weight of this tree also at least write down after finding a spanning tree. In previous example of Kruskal's algorithm, I forgot that you should write down that weight there. Okay, 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. This is the minimum weight is here. So this is how much? 8. Right. Now similarly like Kruskal's algorithm, let me give one example as a homework to you of this one also. So use Prim's algorithm to find a minimal spanning tree in a graph. Let me give a graph to you. Suppose the graph having these vertices, okay, suppose this is A, suppose A, B, C, D, E, F and what, G. Now the edges are, the weights of these edges 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 7, 5, 2 and 4 suppose. So find out this minimal spanning tree using Prim's algorithm. Let me give as a homework to you this one also. Okay. So now here we will stop for this one. In next video we will see Emery trees and its properties. Thank you.